Langley, OGT here with you. So, by lots and lots of requests, let's go there and react to there's something wrong with my baby. Let's go. All right, so really, introduction-wise, when something's wrong with my baby, Jimmy Barnes and John Farnham. May 7th, 2013. There we go. When something's wrong with my baby. Is a song written by Isaac Hayes and David Porter. In 1991, Australian singers Jimmy Barnes and John Farnham recorded and released When Something's Wrong With My Baby as a second single from Barnes' fifth studio album, Soul Deep. Love that name. The song peaked at number 3 in Australia, number 6 in New Zealand. The two biggest singers in Australia cover a song together that peaked at number 3. Okay. So it looks like this song has been done by several people throughout the years. Sorry to give that funny face. That just don't make sense. As much as John and Jimmy, I mean, what songs in Australia took number 1 and number 2 at that time? Yeah, wow. So the song was written in 1967 by Hayes and Porter. Vocals by Sam Moore, Booker T and the MGs. I've seen where Al Pacino asked a girl to dance with him, the Stand Up Guys. It was in there. This song was also featured in Edgar Wright's 2017 Baby Driver. I've seen that. Peaked on the U.S. Billboard at 42 on the R&B hit songs at 2. That was in 67. So it does definitely look like Barnes and Farnham's cover of it done better than any, including the original. Charlie Rich recorded it in October 16 of 66, but the first time released in 88 compilation album, I'll Shed Their Tears. Otis Redding, Carla Thomas on their 67 album, Queen and King, King and Queen. Sonny James in 76. Hey, shout out to Sonny James. Hall & Oates, shout out to Hall & Oates. Dave Rubin, Eddie Kendrick of the Temptations, Apollo at their Apollo Theater. Wow, 85. That's right around the first moonwalk. Our first time Michael did it. Actually, if you research that, the moonwalk was done way before Michael Jackson. Although he did it best, I believe, I'm sure. Linda Ronstadt and Aaron Neville. Hey! Fred's ever talked about Love and Linda Ronstadt. Top 5 duet from the 1990 triple platinum album, Cry Like a Rainstorm. What's going into it? Patti LaBelle and Travis Tritt, country singers. 1994. Frankie Miller, 2 live versions of it. Yeah, I mean, lots and lots of people. The Paris Theater, it was done. The Golden Green Hippodrome in London. Herman Broad and His Wild Romance did it. Sissy Houston. Guy Sebastian sung the song in a duet with Jimmy Barnes. And original Stax band Booker T and the MGs in Sydney, Australia during the Memphis tour. From his album, I'll Still Be Loving You. Pete Nunn, 67 on the Billboard Hot Country Charts. American Folk, Yeah, man. I mean, this song's been done by almost everyone. Good Lord, look at the people. Charlie Rich. Yeah, goodness gracious. Well, yeah, Jimmy Barnes and John. John and Jimmy. Jimmy and John, they did it best. It says actually Sam and Dave have more, the most sales. Then it's Jimmy Barnes and John Barnes. So, let's get into it. Okay, now that we know everyone under the sun and every continent everywhere has sung this song, I will say that I think John and Jimmy have made it most famous. That's heart good with the voice, you're the voice. Because the only time I've heard of this song, and the first people you pull up when you Google it, or not Google it, friggin' Wikipedia, that's what comes up, it's John and Jimmy. So, let's enjoy it. Let's get into it. You ready, OGL?
I am ready. John and Jimmy, don't let us down.
And technology neither. Uh-oh, I just jinxed this.
Oh, yeah. Here we go.
We got this shit. All right. Here we go.
So, I was saying, we've been lucky to have Diesel sing and play with us. Extremely lucky. We're also very, very lucky to have John Farnham sing with us. Thank you! Because I don't have to give a high bit. Something is wrong with my baby. You know that something is wrong with me. And if I know she's a worry.
All right, good Lord have mercy. I can see why you have been requesting this so much. So, oh, I don't know if I told you all, but in the last reaction that I just done, right before this one, I found out that technology was a problem. And the damn it, I was going to say it's simple, the solution, but pen and paper, but I'm having trouble finding my pen. Got it. So all we do is when we stop it, we're at 121. That's my stopping point. Write it down, pen and paper, solved all our damn problems. Now back to the damn reaction. Okay. Go ahead, Greg.
First of all, kind of weird seeing Jimmy in a suit. That threw me right off the bat. Then he starts singing like that. That's a smoother sound than I'm used to hearing coming out of Jimmy. And then a couple bars later, he gets into much more, let's call it a Jimmy-centric sound, which I'm all in favor of, completely down with. I love his grit. I love his soul. And I love how he's got, at this point, he's already developed a lot more control over it. His voice has matured a lot, which is awesome. There's a cool kind of a skipping drum beat there in the beginning, too, that I really liked. Then when John comes in, John's got that, man, that awesome, yeah, it sits a little bit higher. It's really smooth. It's really powerful. It's got a lot of cut, and they're getting into it right off the bat. Their harmonies were great. John was doing some high belts there that sounded amazing. And this is, we're just like, not even a minute and a half in. So this is already amazing. I can't wait to see where it goes. How about you?
Well, I would call that a Jimmy and John Gasm.
Most definitely.
In the tool world, we call it a tool gasm. House of Chains called a Wayne gasm. You know, when you have a gasm, that's a good thing. So anything you put in front of it's good. Well, I retract that statement. There are some things you can put in there that aren't good. But anyway, that's the off subject. Way off subject, actually. So let's, I agree about the voices, their contrast. And it seems like, when singers cut their damn hair, they grow up. Is that true or am I just crazy? Because
it's like visual shorthand. We are mature now.
Right. It's like, look at me. I got a haircut. I'm grown up.
So it's like, I got better things to do than take care of my long hair on tour. So off it goes.
Yeah, like, I guess I was opposite in the tattoo world because I didn't have tattoos when I was a drug addict most of my life. But you got a gym, get a bunch of tattoos.
I mean, when I got tired of taking care of my hair, I took a much more drastic solution, so.
All right, so what we're going to do is easy. We're going to start this over. Back to the beginning. Let's do it. Something is wrong with my baby. You know that something is wrong with me. And if I know she's a worry. That's a good sound point right there. Oh, so I'll start this one. The gravel and Jimmy's voice we always talk about, and then the beautiful in John's voice. John just said some gravel right there. John just threw in the distortion like it wasn't nothing. Ain't quite on Jimmy's level there, but still. And then the falsetto bravado belt, whatever the hell that was he just did. Was we'll say Over the Top. If you get that reference, you're badass in my opinion. Yeah, thank you, GL.
100% agree with everything you said. I think it's kind of funny. We think of Jimmy as being very having a very rough character to his voice, and John having a very smooth character. But this song they've already showed multiple times. Jimmy can be smooth when he wants to be, and John can be rough when he wants to be as well. So it's kind of nice seeing them kind of as a. Like, I've heard a lot of songs where you have one clean voice and then they have one gravelly voice, and they kind of stay in their roles, and that's cool. But I like how these guys are going back and forth with that. You know, sometimes one of them will be, you know, sometimes Jimmy will be smooth and John will put that distortion in. Sometimes they switch it. They have coordinated some runs, like, really, really well, like, spot on. We've joked before with some of the earlier Jimmy videos about him sort of being in the moment and sort of, you know, possibly some alcoholic enhancement going on. But he clearly knows exactly what he's doing as a singer, because, like, you cannot coordinate runs like that without knowing precisely where you're at. Really amazing to hear. Yeah, John on this verse is absolutely tearing it up. Again, he can be so smooth, but he can put that grit in there. there's just the vocal fireworks in this song are just, they're just amazing. The instrumental is basically just sitting it's a very cool groove, but it's not designed to stand out. I'm pretty sure I've said this in a previous song.
I'll tell you what, I'm not trying to cut you off, but...
No, go ahead.
For all you musicians out there, no matter what you play, you might have two great musicians. We'll go with guitar. One who's awesome on the power chords and the riffs and the heavy stuff, and one who plays melodic, Jeff Beckley type, beautiful solos, high chords. Well, you get two together, and they can't do each other's crap quite as well, but they riff off each other, the two guitars. And that's exactly what they're doing vocally, is riffing off each other just like guitars do. That almost made me cry. I don't know why. That was, that was a damn good analogy, Danny.
These guys obviously like performing with each other, because you can tell they're bringing out the best. Like I said, they're playing off of each other. It feels very immediate. Although I'm sure they practice their asses off on this, but this doesn't feel like something that's been choreographed or coordinated. This, both guys are in the moment, both guys are pouring their heart and soul out, and, you know, the band behind them has got a really cool groove going that lets these guys just go and do their thing.
Hell yeah. All right, let's get back to it.
We'll be right back.
Hell. Well, I said we were going to go back. I let the son of a bitch go. Oh, man. I'm sorry, guys. I was going to say that last solo again.
Loop a reel.
Yeah, the technology I have in place won't let me go back. I'm just gone. Oh. Hell, we are a blooper reel, guys. You know? So
it's a very abrupt ending, though, for such an awesome song.
And just the way they were. Is that, by the way, is that Ian Moss that was singing with him?
I think that's a guy named Johnny Diesel.
That's right. You told me that. That's,
yes.
Yeah. It's a show or something. Or is that the name of this entertainment award ceremony is Diesel or something? Correct. We said it in the beginning. I just don't remember what the other name of it is.
Yeah, Australian Awards and Diesel Show, yeah.
All right, so let's meet back in the lounge, Greg, and we'll do the outro. This was a great freaking song, man. I love it.
If I could say one thing before we wrap up here.
We're not wrapping up. We're just...
Right, but I was just thinking of that. It's like someone thought that the song wasn't awesome enough. So it's like, okay, let's have this awesome guitar solo, which that had some great bite to it. Like, his sound wasn't quite as robust as Joe Bonamassa's, but it had like that Albert Collins cold twangy bite to it that just like cut right through. And Jimmy is just like I said this before, he's a force of nature. Like, I feel like there's something inside him that just has to come out. It's like even when he's not singing, he's randomly will make a sound or will do like a quick little riff or just do something there to punctuate something. Again, it's always awesome. It's always, like, right on point. It always adds to the song. But, yeah, it's like asking him to stay silent for any extended period of time. It's like, it's not going to happen. And I, for one, am happy about that. So, yeah, it's another killer track from both of these guys who can seemingly do no wrong.
Man, I concur with that statement. For sure. So, much love. We actually got engaged. I got to take my neighbor to the store. So, but we're going to meet right back here together, do the outro. You won't know the difference. I don't know how I told you.
Seem like no one ever left. But Danny's an honest guy, so.
Yeah, it's a curse sometimes, guys. It's a freaking curse sometimes.
And he's doing a favor for a neighbor, so that's just Danny. He's a good Samaritan.
Doing a favor for my neighbor! Guys, sorry. That was a fucking tangent. Or a scream or something. Plus the breathing treatment. You know how it is. Much love. See you in a second.
Hello, everybody. Last time you saw me, I was at home at my computer, jamming with my boy Danny Lee OGT to some fantastic soulful balladeering. Now I'm in the vestibule. I mean, our reactions are as real as they get, guys. You can't fake enthusiasm like Danny's, but sometimes we have to do some work in post. So here I am at a completely different location to tell you all, thank you so much for stopping by. Thank you for enjoying this with us. We hope you had as good a time as we did. This was a great song. I can see why so many people have covered it. As always, Jimmy and John just knocked it out of the park. It is always a pleasure to listen to either of those guys, and especially both. So thank you all very much. We will see you here next time. Mental health is real. Let's be a part of the start. And remember, guys, sometimes your music collection can be your best support group. I have a great day.